we are live?
In a second, it's working. Du bist jetzt live.
So, herzlich willkommen einmal mehr at Point Cutter Studio. Welcome you that joining us for our day-to-day haircutting session. I'm very proud that you invest some time to watch me and what we're gonna do today. We're gonna plan to make a classic graduated long bob. Herzlichen Dank dafür, dass ihr eure Zeit heute investiert, um mit mir einen klassischen Long Bob zu erarbeiten. Wie ihr vielleicht wisst, haben wir das letzte Mal einen sehr kreativen Haarschnitt gemacht. Sehr artistisch, mit vielen Slice-Cutting und Point-Cutting-Techniken. Dieses Mal wollen wir einen sehr basisorientierten Haarschnitt machen. Last time, we made a very creative haircutting using slice cutting and point cutting techniques in different ways. So I decide for today we're gonna do a very basic oriented haircut. So the classic graduated long bob is one of the most wanted haircuts in salon. Der klassische graduierte long bob ist einer der am meisten begehrtesten Haarschnitte im Salon. Und das schon seit mehreren Jahren. You use this haircut for more than 10 years now. But to be honest, many hairdressers have challenges with this haircut. Viele Friseure haben immer noch Herausforderungen mit dieser Form. Und vielleicht kann ich euch heute eine Idee geben, wie ihr eure Schwierigkeiten lösen könnt, wie ihr diesen Haarschnitt noch dynamischer, noch erfolgreicher bei euren Kunden umsetzen könnt. Maybe I give you an idea and a technical procedure how you can make this haircut more successful and bring it to more heads of your clients in your salon. I already made my department in the beginning, and as you can see, I'm using a contour department. That means that the divisions we do follow the hairline and it has the same wideness all over the head. I did the same on the other side as well. Wie ihr sehen könnt, habe ich bereits hier die Konturenabteilung vorgenommen. Die Konturenabteilung ist eine Einteilung, die euch bei diesem Haarschnitt sehr helfen wird, eine schöne, diagonal nach vorne verlaufende Form zu bekommen. Wichtig hierbei, dass ihr die Breite der Konturenabteilung um den gesamten Konturenverlauf gleich wählt. Speziell im Bereich hinter dem Ohr werden viele zu dünn. Und gerade hier wird die Fülle benötigt. Especially the area behind the ear is important, that you have enough hair here, because when you do the graduation from the nape area through the sides, you need fullness behind the ear. When we now start doing this haircut, we work from the frontal area to the nape. Many of you will normally work beginning in the nape and working through the face. As you can see, the way backwards makes it much easier. Because when you analyze the form and you see you have two different lines in this haircut. You have a diagonal line on the side and you will later have a concave line in the back. And the concave line is much harder to cut because it's a round line. And the diagonal line, it's a straight line. That makes it much easier when you begin with a straight line and move into the curved line. Warum beginne ich diesen Haarschnitt von vorne nach hinten zu erarbeiten? Viele von euch würden ihn wahrscheinlich im Nacken beginnen. Aber wenn ihr euch diesen Haarschnitt einmal vorstellt, dann seht ihr, dass der Haarschnitt in der Nackenpartie eine konkave Linie aufweist und an der Seite eine gerade Linie. Leichter zu schneiden für euch ist aber die gerade Linie. Es macht also Sinn, diesen Haarschnitt vom Gesicht zum Nacken hin zu erarbeiten, also mit der Diagonalen, mit der geraden Linie zu beginnen. Genau das werde ich jetzt tun und ihr werdet anhand meiner Arbeitsweise sehen, wie diese Arbeitsweise funktioniert. Und vielleicht ist sie auch etwas für euch. So I'm gonna start my haircut now and you can follow my workflow. And maybe the way cutting from the face through the nail is the ideal for you to make this haircut more successful. So please take care that the hair is in the same wetness all over the contour area. The scissor I'm gonna use is an English haircutting scissor because we will not do any texturizing techniques today. We don't do any point cutting or slice cutting. We really focused on a very exact way of cutting this line. So that's the reason why an English haircutting scissor is the best one for this.
I have a question. We'll display again later. I want to do the cut with you.
Yeah. So you can watch the full video later on and maybe you have a chance to repeat this haircut. So I'm gonna start this here on the side. I comb the hair in the natural fall and position my fingers in a strong diagonal forward position. I move a little bit so you can see how strong this diagonal finger position is. Es ist sehr wichtig, dass ihr zu Beginn dieses Haarschnitts die Fingerposition steil diagonal nehmt. Please keep in mind, if you cut a long bob, the length around the face will a little go up when you do the blow drying later on. And if your diagonal line is not strong enough, you have the problem that the client later on does not see this diagonal line anymore. So when you cut a long bob compared to a classical bob in this length, be sure that your diagonal finger position is much stronger for a long bob. So I comb the hair in the natural fall, position my fingers in a very strong diagonal position and cut my line through the nape area. Ich kämme die Haare im natürlichen Fall und schneide meine diagonale Linie konsequent zur Nackenpartie. So when I show you here my monocle, you can see that I do that diagonal line into the nape area and only the concave line in the middle of the nape will create it later on. The diagonal line will go through the nape areas beginning from the face. So, versichert euch, dass eure Linienführung auch sehr exakt verläuft. Das bedeutet, kontrolliert diese Schnittlinie noch einmal, bevor ihr zur zweiten Seite übergeht. I make a double check of this line before I go to the other side and do the same here. I comb the hair still in the natural fall, taking control about my diagonal finger position. I double check once again to make sure that the line is very exact and totally correct. When I now move ahead to the nape area, you see I have diagonal ends here And what I have now to do is to make a compact form from the middle, first through one side and next to the other. What I'm gonna do now, a Bassnackenpartie. It's important that you start from the middle of the nape area, first to one side and then through the other. Your scissor should be every time in a 0 degrees position. So take care that you not turn your fingers through the outside. If you do that, the hair comes out later on and you create a wave inside it. Take control that you have a perfect symmetry in your line and do a little correction if necessary. Überprüft noch einmal eure Linienführung und wenn ihr eine Unregelmäßigkeit in der Linie findet, dann korrigiert das, bevor ihr zum nächsten Schritt übergeht. So, if the line is finished, next step is to put the head a little bit forward. And comb the hair through the skin, make a correction if there are some swirls, like for example in the neck.
Can you make the mannequin a little bit?
Now the first sequence is finished and we continue with cutting the next partings. And what we're gonna do now is making diagonal partings and we do one more solid form in the nape before we start with the graduation. But this depends on how much hair your client has. If it has a lots of hair, you can maybe go directly into the graduated form. For me personal, when I'm going to do a long bob, I love it when you see the line on the outer area, when this line is very exact. So I prefer doing a second parting solid form before I start with the graduated form. Wenn ich einen long bob im Salon erarbeite, liebe ich es, wenn die Konturenschnittlinie kompakt ist und auch nach dem Föhnen deutlich sichtbar. Deshalb bevorzuge ich es, bei einem Long Bob noch eine zweite kompakte Abteilung zu schneiden, bevor ich in die Graduation übergehe. Now I use my comb to bring the hair in the right position. I'm using my scissor to push the hair a little bit through the head and cutting my solid form to make sure that this line is very exact when the hair is dry later. Mit meiner Schere schiebe ich das Haar zur Kopfrundung und schneide die kompakte Form, um sicher zu sein, dass wenn es dann getrocknet ist, diese Schnittlinie auch sehr exakt ist. So when this step is done, I go back in the natural head position and as you can see how exact the line is, especially with such a slightly curly manicure, you can see the exact line is.
Can you maybe just bring it a little bit closer because some of them are saying that they cannot see properly the cut.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So. Okay. Now we do the next step, and this is a graduated sequence. You're going to start from the A-axis and do a diagonal sequence. Normally it's about 5 centimeters wide. And this sequence will bring a lot of movement into this haircut. It pushes the fullness of the hair up to the swirl area, and this gives later on this progressive form what the long bob is used to.
You have one question.
Yes.
Can you please recommend a good comb for layering?
We do not, let us not speak about combs and scissors now. We try to be focused on the haircut, and we maybe talk about this in direct messaging later on. This, I think this makes it more interesting for everybody to see how this haircut is done. Now I have a diagonal forward sequence. The wideness is about 5 centimeters. And I now begin cutting this graduated sequence in the middle at the A-axis. I comb the hair, and I bring you in a better position. I comb the hair in a 45 degrees away from the head. You can see this is 90 degrees and this is 45. And my finger position is also 45 degrees. This is 90, and this is 0, and this is 45 degrees. So I comb the hair, and when you take a closer look, you can see the end of your solid form here. And from this length, you start doing the graduation. Take care that if you comb the hair vertical, that you not start cutting from this shorter length through, because you make it the nape area too short and the solid form is gone away. So leave the longest hair here and start from the longest point in a 45 degrees finger position. Take care that you have a good connection through the nape area. So guys, I just make a little mistake. I forgot one clip. So give me just a second, and I'm back. I need one more to that you can better see how I do this cut. I'm sorry. Here it is. I'm back, and with this clip, you can better see how I'm gonna do this cut. This clip, I normally not use it in salon. It's only for workshop. It's only for you that you can better see how I do comb the hair, how I cut it. So that's the reason why I forgot it. So excuse me once more. So, diesen Clip hier benutze ich normalerweise im Salon nicht. Das ist ausschließlich für einen Workshop gedacht, weil ich hier die Haare einmal wegnehme, sodass ihr die Einteilung und die Kämmrichtung des Haarschnitts gut erkennen könnt. So, what we now gonna do is, we start on the highest point. It's our pivot point here. And from this pivot point, we do partenings diagonal forward. We comb the hair in a rectangular distribution. Take control about our guideline, and we still continue with the 45 degrees and the parallel finger position. We start partening from the highest point diagonal forward. I use my clip that you can better see it. I comb the hair in a rectangular distribution. I lift it, take control about my guideline, and cut through the guideline. You can see here that I create a little overlapping in this area behind the ear. That's not a mistake, because later I cut this hair on my contour line, so it's not any problem. It depends how strong your graduated form will be. So, one more pivotal parting. And still continue with the workflow. So. And one last continue. Rectangular distribution. What does that mean? If you take your comb and you put it back in your parting, then the teeth of your comb show you the right direction you should comb the hair. I put the comb here inside this parting, and you see the teeth of my comb show me how I should comb it. And the rectangular distribution helps you a lot creating very precise graduation. When you are done with it, make a double check with your contour line, and you can see I have a very little overlapping here, and I'm gonna remove this. And my form is visible now. Wenn ihr eine rechtwinklige Kämmrichtung arbeiten möchtet, dann hilft euch euer Haarschneidekamm. Ihr nehmt den Kamm, legt den Rücken in die Abteilung hinein, und die Zähne des Kammes zeigen euch immer die rechtwinklige Kämmrichtung. Das ist wichtig, denn durch die rechtwinklige Kämmrichtung bekommt ihr sehr weich und sehr präzise verlaufende Graduationen, speziell in der Nackenpartie, aber auch später, wenn wir im Oberkopfbereich arbeiten. Wenn ihr die Graduation fertig erarbeitet habt, dann kämmt das Haar noch einmal in den natürlichen Fall, und wenn ihr hier ein sanftes Overlapping in der Kontur habt, entfernt er die Haare. So, now we're going back to the middle, because this first section we did is our guideline for the other side as well. And we now continue doing the pivotal parting. We start from here and we go diagonal forward. I take my clip so that you can see it better. I comb the hair into a rectangular distribution so I can double check it. Now I'm gonna cut my guideline. Next part of it. Starting from the highest point. You start from the highest point all the time. Here in the middle at the A-axis.
take care that the water, there's enough water at your hair, and the wetness of the hair is at the same level when you're doing the haircut. Wichtig ist, dass ihr die Feuchtigkeit des Haares immer auf dem gleichen Niveau haltet während des gesamten Haarschnittes, weil sonst durch die Unterschiedlichkeit des Ausdehnens der Haare ihr ein unpräzises Ergebnis bekommt. So now I'm gonna do the last sequence, the last parting.
Können Sie bitte mal beschreiben, schreiben? Is it weird?
Later on, when the demonstration and the live session is being finished, you will get the drawings, the graphics, and the images of the final result. And if you go to my YouTube channel, you find descriptions of this haircut as well. Okay, now we finish the graduated sequence in the nape area and we move ahead to the top area. What we're now gonna do is we cut first one side and then we cut the other side. Maybe you are used to working on both sides at the same time. Please note, this is at the end more complicated, especially when you work with a rectangular distribution I do. It's much easier when you first do one side, completely done, and then you move to the other side. And it also makes you faster. Wenn wir jetzt zum Oberkopfbereich weitergehen, ist es wichtig, dass ihr zuerst eine Seite bearbeitet und dann die andere Seite. Möglicherweise sind viele von euch gewohnt, beide Seiten parallel zu arbeiten. Aber das Ganze wird dadurch nur komplizierter. Speziell, da wir ja bei diesem Haarschnitt eine rechtwinklige Kämmrichtung benutzen wollen. Und es wird viel einfacher und viel schneller, wenn wir erst die eine Seite arbeiten und dann die andere. So. You may see that we have a side parting here. I decide to make this haircut a little bit asymmetric. So. And if you do it with a side pardoning, you do the first side you cut on the top area is the smaller ones. So my side pardoning is here. That means I'm doing this side first and then I move to the longer ones. Wenn ihr einen Seitenscheitel benutzt, wie ich es hier getan habe, ist es wichtig, dass ihr zuerst immer die kleine Seite arbeitet. Denn diese ist ein bisschen einfacher von der Arbeitsweise und vom Vorgehen. Und dadurch wird das Ganze für euch auch schneller und einfacher umsetzbar. So. Now we continue with diagonal forward partings, beginning in the nape area. Still in the rectangular distribution, and the position, my finger position, is still 45 degrees. One of the most mistakes is that people now, when they're cutting the hair on the top of the head, go lower with their angle. And this is a problem because it gives you too much weight on the top area, and when you do the blow drying, the graduation is gone away. So please continue with the 45 degrees angle. and follow the guideline around the head. Ich sehe sehr oft, wenn ich diesen Haarschnitt unterrichte, dass junge Leute beim Nachvollziehen im Deckhaarbereich den Abhebewinkel flacher wählen als die 45 Grad, welche wir zu Beginn hatten. Es ist sehr wichtig, dass ihr diesen 45 Grad Winkel unbedingt einhaltet, denn anders kreiert ihr zu viel Gewicht am Oberkopf und die Graduation, die ihr im Nacken erarbeitet habt, ist dann weg oder kaum sichtbar. Oder es gibt sogar eine leichte Kante. So, as you can see here, now I'm in the same height that my diagonal line goes straight through the face. That means I do now one more section in the nape area, and then I continue in doing it from about the whole side. So we start here and go through the face, follow this diagonal line. Ich bin jetzt mit meiner diagonalen Linie auf der Höhe angekommen, dass ich sie bei der nächsten Abteilung dann nach vorne durchziehen kann. Und das werde ich auch tun. Wir schneiden eine letzte Partie ausschließlich im Nacken und gehen dann über die Seitenpartie mit zu erarbeiten. Now I did a complete diagonal forward pardoning and I start from the nape and follow this line through the face all around the head form. And I'm still staying in the rectangular distribution and the 45 degrees angle. Especially in the side area here, one of the most mistakes people make is combing the hair in the natural distribution. But if you do this, you create too much heaviness around the face and the form is not consistently. So take care that you still use a rectangular distribution in the side area and take a look where your guideline is and cut the length off. This will guarantee that your graduation is consistently from the nape area through the face. Speziell im Bereich um das Gesicht ist einer der am häufigsten gemachten Fehler der, dass die Haare im vorderen Seitenbereich in den natürlichen Fall gekämmt werden. Und dadurch keine Graduation entsteht, sondern eine kompakte Form. In diesem Fall kreiert ihr um das Gesicht herum zu viel Gewicht und nehmt dem Haarschnitt die Leichtigkeit. Deshalb ist es wichtig, wenn ihr die Seitenpartien schneidet, ihr seht es gleich hier, dass ihr mit der recht engwinkligen Kämmrichtung fortfahrt und die Haare tatsächlich auch in dem entsprechenden 45 Grad Winkel schneidet. So we continue with this workflow in the same way to the front area. In dieser Art und Weise fahren wir jetzt fort und schneiden den gesamtlichen restlichen Seitenbereich und achten jeweils auf die rechtwinklige Kämmrichtung und den 45 Grad Abhebewinkel. Wenn ihr unsicher seid, achtet darauf, dass ihr immer den Kamm in die Abteilung hineinlegen könnt und die Zähne des Kamms zeigen euch immer, wie ihr die Haare kämmen solltet. So I'm continuing to the front hairline. And then my first side is finished.
Just a short info. The live is going to be saved, and for all of you that are asking questions about tutoring, schooling, and all the things that are not related to the hairstyle now, would be really perfect if you could make messages to the DM so that you can speak about it, about the conditions, yeah?
So you spoke to the audience.
Speaking to the audience.
So maybe you come in front of the camera, nobody sees you. Please come around. This is my assistant, Diana. And she's taking care that you get the best pictures then possible. Thank you. And she helps me answering your questions. And like she said, if you have special questions, not close connected to this haircut, it's better I answer them later on, or you send a direct message or something like that. So now we are done with the first side, and you can see the graduation. It starts from the nape, it goes through the face, you see the diagonal line contour, and you see the graduation is still consistently also in the side area. We have not a solid form here, we still have a graduation there. And this gives this haircut more flexibility and makes it lighter and easier to wear for your client. Now we go to the other side and work the same way. And this side now is the bigger ones. That means the side parting gives us more weightness on this side, and I will later on speak about the side parting because it's very important that you do it the right way. But now I first finish my graduation and then I explain you some facts about the side parting. So I'm still using the same technique. I comb the hair diagonal forward, I use a rectangular distribution. Your comb and the teeth of the comb will help you to find the right position. And I work from the nape through the face. I first do two partings in the nape area, and then I continue doing the side part as well. maybe some of you are used to working first the nape area and later doing the side area. So maybe it's an idea that you try it one time, like I do it, because if you do it connected from the nape through the side, section for section, it helps you to make a continuing, a consistent graduated form. This helps you. If you split it and first do the nape area and then continue with the side area, you're always in trouble having the same consistent graduation than you have in the nape area. That's a big challenge. So maybe this is a better way. Einige von euch sind vielleicht gewohnt, zuerst die Graduation in der Nackenpartie zu beenden und dann die Haare im Seitenbereich zu arbeiten. Es entsteht dann immer ein Problem, dass die Graduation möglicherweise nicht gleichmäßig nach vorne durchläuft. Gerade durch die rechtwinklige Kämmrichtung, die ich hier nutze, ist das eine besondere Herausforderung. Vielleicht ist es eine gute Idee, dass ihr es einfach einmal probiert, in dieser Art und Weise, und vielleicht überzeugt euch das Ergebnis dieser gleichmäßigen, nach vorne durchlaufenden Graduation, dass ihr diesen Arbeitsweg für die Zukunft wählt.
Okay, we have two questions. Mm-hmm. What if they don't want as much length in the front but still graduated?
If you want less length, your diagonal line is a bit is not so steep. It's a little bit more flat. That's the only difference. Then the diagonal pardoning is not so strong. It's a little bit more flat. It's like this, and then you can use this technique for any result. Only the horizontal bob should be worked a bit different.
And the second one, do you post videos in other places, like courses where they can buy it?
Yeah, at Udemy. I do, you can buy videos, especially this haircut is at Udemy since maybe 6 months. So Udemy is a platform, some of you may know it. You can buy lessons. And you find a workshop, it's called Perfect Bob. And this Perfect Bob workshop contains the long bob, in the same way I do it here, a shorter bob and a very short bob. So it's three haircuts inside. So you can find it out at Udemy, and you type in Marcus Kurt, and then you will come through my landing page there. For some of you which are interested in our free materials, you find it YouTube, you will find it Facebook, you will find videos also at Pinterest. So take a closer look. I think we have now more than 100 videos, and I think the video you like to watch should be there. Für die von euch, die gerne einen Online-Workshop absolvieren möchten, es gibt eine Plattform, auf der sind Kaufvideos erhältlich. Sie heißt Udemy. Und wenn ihr dort meinen Namen eingebt, dann gelangt ihr zur Landingpage und dort könnt ihr verschiedene Haarschneidevideos auch kaufen, unter anderem das Video oder den Workshop Perfect Bob, der aus drei verschiedenen Lektionen besteht. Einmal der Long Bob, wie ich ihn hier zeige, genauso aber auch der klassische graduierte Bob und ein kurzer Bob. Schaut einfach mal rein. Für die von euch, die gerne freies Material sich anschauen möchten, wir haben auf den diversen Plattformen mittlerweile weit über 100 Haarschnitte.
Und ich denke, der Richtige wird für euch schon dabei sein. Ihr findet uns auf Pinterest, ihr findet uns auf Instagram, YouTube natürlich, Facebook, überall. Und ich denke, der Haarschnitt, den ihr sucht, den werdet ihr in der Regel zumindest auch dort finden.
What is your name in Udemy?
Markus Kurt. My name at Udemy is Markus Kurt.
Mit C.
Mit C.
C. Kurt mit C.
Yeah. Because they did not accept Point Cutter. I tried to name it Point Cutter, but they don't accept it. So, they want to have my real name. So Point Cutter is my nickname, and my real name is Markus Kurt. So, now we are done. And if you take a look at the result, you see that we have a little asymmetric form here. And now is the point where I ask my client if she likes it when it's a little bit asymmetric, because it's coming from this area here, because we had a side parting in here, and we combed the hair in through this side, so that means the wave for the hair is a little bit longer, and the diagonal line is going more forward than the smaller side. And that's the reason why the form looks a little bit asymmetric. I personally prefer this asymmetric way, but if your client don't like it and wants to have a little connection, you can do it very easily when you make a diagonal parting from the smaller side through the longer side. And you cut a little connection here around the face. This is a kind of a compromise for your client if they want to have not a disconnected form here. So, and then the classic long bob is done. And I will now do a blow dry and show you the result later on. But I have one big point I want to inform you of, and this is the side parting. For me as an artist, there are two side partings existing. The first one is the side parting of your client when their hair is dry, when your client does the blow drying. And the other one is when you cut it. It's the cutting side parting. And when you do a cutting side parting, put my mannequin a little bit forward so you can better see it. It's really important that you start in the middle of the eyebrow and you move diagonal to the highest point of the head. Most hairdressers make it too straight and take too much hair from the smaller side through the longer side. And then it happens every time that when your client moves the head, these longer sections fall through the shorter ones, and it looks that you forgot some hair to cut. So, if you do the parting, start at the highest point of the eyebrow, go vertical from this point to the highest point, and then you make the side parting only for cutting. When you later do the blow dry, of course you can move the side parting away from the highest point, because normally the clients love to get it like that. But as a hairdresser, you are on the safe side, because now you take shorter lengths and put it to the longer side. It's better instead of longer lengths putting to the shorter side, because normally they will overlap here, and then your client does think you did not cut exactly. So this is the final result of the graduated form, and you can see such a haircut I can do in salon in 20 to 25 minutes. It doesn't matter if I have long hair cutting too short, or I only do a correction in cutting about 1 centimeter or two. Dieser Haarschnitt ist in 20 bis 25 Minuten im Salon perfekt umsetzbar. Und es ist eine Form, die sehr gebräuchlich ist. Dabei spielt es gar keine Rolle, ob ihr eine große Länge abschneidet oder vielleicht nur einen Korrekturschnitt von 1 bis 2 Zentimetern macht. Die Arbeitszeit ist immer die gleiche. Wichtig ist, dass ihr diesen Arbeitsablauf verinnerlicht und ihn entsprechend umsetzt. Und dann seid ihr immer auf der sicheren Seite. If you're following my workflow, you will always be on the safe side. And there are 2 big points that you should have in mind when you're starting this haircut. The first thing is the contour line. Start cutting from the face through the nape area. This is important and gives you control about the outer contour line. And the next thing is, start from the nape and walk through one side first, and then you work the other side. This helps you having more consistency in your graduation and helps you taking control about the form, especially on the sides. 2 wichtige Punkte zum Schluss. Wichtig zum Einstieg in diesen Haarschnitt ist die Konturenabteilung. Die Konturenabteilung gibt euch eine Kontrolle über den Verlauf eurer Formlinie und dass ihr sicher seid, solange ihr diese Konturenlinie nicht zerstört, habt ihr immer einen sauberen Abschluss der Frisur. Der 2. Punkt ist, dass ich erst eine Seite arbeite und dann die andere und nicht den Nacken zuerst. Denn dadurch gewinne ich Kontrolle über die Graduierung und schaffe mir eine durchgängig gleichbleibende Steilheit in der Graduation. So, this was the graduated long bob. Now I'm gonna do my blow drying. And I will post the final result after blow drying in about 20 to 25 or 30 minutes. So give me a little time. So today we are not come back a second time because we do not do any dry cutting on this haircut yet. So it's time, guys, that I thank you for spending some time, investing some time to watching me doing this haircut. And I hope it helps you creating more long bobs in your salon to your clients. Danke, dass ihr eure Zeit für mich investiert habt, dass ihr euch den long bob, den klassischen long bob angeschaut habt. Und ich hoffe, diese Investition an Zeit hat sich für euch gelohnt. Und ihr könnt mehr long bobs auf die Köpfe eurer Kunden bringen. We will come back a second time in April to show you a next haircut. So follow our sites and you will see advertising for our next live session. And of course, I promise you, we will go into longer haircuts. We do layers in every variation, so you have a full repertoire of haircuts when the summer is come. Bis zum Sommer werden wir noch verschiedene Live-Workshops machen und wir werden auch lange gestufte Formen erarbeiten, sodass ihr ein tolles Repertoire an verschiedenen Haarschnitten habt, die ihr dann euren Kunden bis zum Sommer präsentieren könnt. So, take care, stay healthy and I hope to see you soon. Bye bye.